Imagine your blood cells are like delivery trucks carrying oxygen. The trucks carry these precious cargoes from the lungs and deliver it throughout the body. Normally, red blood cells are disc-shaped and flexible enough to move easily through the blood vessels and deliver oxygen. People with sickle cell disease are born with genetically abnormal blood cells. There is a gene mutation, a tiny flaw in the building blocks of red blood cell. As a result, the red blood cells, or the trucks that carry oxygen, are wonky or faulty. They are sickle-shaped rather than spherical and don't run very well. These wonky blood cells clog up small blood vessels, leading to potentially life-threatening episodes of pain and risks of vaso-occlusive crises, or strokes. The recurrence of these events can lead to life-threatening disabilities and even early death. Sickle cell disease requires lifelong and repeated blood transfusions. Exa-cel is an exciting new investigational gene therapy developed to treat sickle cell disease. It uses the revolutionary CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing technology to modify patients' own blood stem cells, potentially offering a one-time cure for this lifelong genetic blood disorder. I'll take you through how Exa-cel works. Doctors first withdraw a small amount of bone marrow from the patient, which contains hematopoietic stem cells, the building blocks of blood cells. In the lab, scientists make a precise edit in the DNA of the collected hematopoietic stem cells. This edit targets a specific gene, BCL11A. To put it simply, Exa-cel is like a special mechanic who fixes the truck. It uses a tool called CRISPR-Cas9, which is like a tiny pair of scissors that can cut and paste DNA. With these scissors, Exa-cel goes into the truck's blueprints, which is the genes, and makes a tiny change. The edited hematopoietic stem cells are then infused back into the patient's bloodstream. The change in the gene tells the factory to start making a different kind of truck, or rather red blood cell, one that's round and smooth, and runs much better. This better truck is fetal hemoglobin, or HbF, the type of hemoglobin that babies have before they're born. It's really good at carrying oxygen, which is why babies don't have the same problems as people with sickle cell disease. Exa-cel helps the body make more fetal hemoglobin, even in adults. So with more fetal hemoglobin in the bloodstream, people with these disorders have fewer painful crises. Increased fetal hemoglobin helps prevent the red blood cells from becoming sickle-shaped, reducing the painful and debilitating vaso-occlusive crises. In addition, increased fetal hemoglobin improves oxygen-carrying capacity, potentially reducing the need for regular blood transfusions. If successful, Exa-cel could potentially offer a single treatment, freeing patients from lifelong treatments like chronic blood transfusions or bone marrow transplants. On November 16, 2023, the UK's Medicines and Healthcare Products Regulatory Agency, MHRA, approved Exa-cel, under the brand name Casgevy, for the treatment of sickle cell disease in patients 12 years and older. This makes it the world's first CRISPR-based gene-edited therapy. Then in early December 2023, the US FDA greenlit Exa-cel for treatment of sickle cell disease. These decisions were based on results from the CLIMB-121 trial. This is an ongoing single-arm, multicenter trial in adult and adolescent patients with sickle cell disease. The primary efficacy outcome was freedom from severe vaso-occlusive episodes, or VOC, for at least 12 consecutive months during the 2 years follow-up period after Exa-cel infusion. At that time, 44 patients with sickle cell disease were treated with Exa-cel. Among the 31 patients who were eligible for the evaluation at the time of analysis, 95% had not had severe pain crises for at least 12 months post-treatment. Despite Exa-cel's regulatory approval, there is still a long road ahead to recovery for most patients with sickle cell disease. The treatment process can be grueling, involving lengthy hospital stays and the need for chemotherapy prior to Exa-cel. The price of treatment could be a restricting factor as well. Exa-cel could cost millions of dollars per patient, posing potential barriers to access for many people. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.